This year, in March of 2022, I was diagnosed with bipolar disorder. I have been terrified about talking about it ever since that diagnosis. I remember retreating into my car and sobbing uncontrollably for about 5 minutes because I didn't know what it meant. I know what the definition of bipolar is. I didn't before I got the diagnosis, but after doing immense research and being informed by my psychiatrist, you know, it really gave me pause and it made a lot of sense. And that's the thing that startled me the most. I've struggled with acute mania and acute depression my whole life. I've had 3 big, great depressions in my life. I would say the first one was in 2008, lasted maybe 3 months. The second one lasted 9 months in between 2012 and 2013. And then most recently, from 2018 to about 2021, was a great depression. And in those years were spurts of just mania of, I'm going to decide to be homeless. I'm going to decide to have a kid after meeting this woman of my dreams within the first 3 months, you know, truly just wild, wild ideas. And those are the good ones. It has changed the way I communicate. It has changed the way I've become public facing on YouTube, the way I control my social presence on Instagram, on Facebook, doesn't matter. And I've talked about it like here and there. I've maybe made a little podcast about filmmakers and mental health here and there. I may have said it here and there, but I've never really like done an old school talking head, talking to the camera sort of diary of a bipolar kid, just thing that I just need to do and get off my chest before I can start talking about films and short films and what I've produced this year and just the incredible year that 2022 was for me. Before I can even do that, I got to talk about getting help. So for those that might be watching this who just click on it because here is a person talking about their mania and their depression, the peaks and valleys, as it were. My name's Knives Monroe. I identify as a filmmaker. I've been a filmmaker for the better part of 20 years. I have 2 kids. I had 2 jobs and I have 2 dogs. I live in Austin, Texas, if I didn't say that already. And I've tried everything in the book, everything to get help. I've done the diets. I've done the fads. I've done the 75 hards. I only went up to like 35 days, but you know, I've done the fasts, I've done the cleanses, I've gotten the therapists, I've gotten the help, I've read the books. I've done and tried everything that I possibly could to better myself and figure out what the fuck is wrong with me. And it took going to a therapist and going to a psychiatrist to be diagnosed with bipolar disorder and to get on medication to actually be the thing that helped. Now, I don't want to talk about which medicine that I'm on because unless I'm being paid by a pharmaceutical crazy amounts of money, I ain't talking about it. Because it's not a one size fits all sort of medication, you know? I got supremely lucky that on the first time I tried something, it helped. Now, I'm the type of person that doesn't even take Tylenol. You know, like when I've been cut, I don't even put Neosporin on the thing. So getting on medication was absolutely wild to me. But it maybe took about a month and a half for the feelings of unaliving myself to go away. The feelings of self-hatred to disappear. Like tears in the rain. This fogginess, this uncertainty dissipated, and I didn't think that was possible. You know, I tested my relationship with Claire, my wife, and I pushed her in ways where if I didn't get help, I don't think she was going to stick around anymore. And I've never said that publicly. but she stuck around and she was the inspiration for me trying to get help because I tried everything. I mean, I listed about 10 things, but I've tried 50 more things on top of that. I've read the self-help books. I've listened to Tony Robbins ad nauseum for the past 15 years. I've tried everything. But the medicine is what helped. And because of that, it's unlocked this creative responsibility and accountability in me that I didn't necessarily think I was capable of. I always thought one day I'll become this actualized, self-realized Maslow of hierarchy, just the top of the list. I always thought like I figure this out and I'd get to the top of the self-actualization. One day I'll be the dream version of me. That day didn't come until I got on medicine and I realized, oh, dude, I'm enough. I'm enough. I'm good enough. Why wait? I could just be today. Now, make no mistake about it. This isn't a matter of being happy. But I don't hate myself right now. And how does that not make you happy? Now, I'm very fortunate in so many ways because there are people, and I've done the research, who have tried my medicine, which is an antipsychotic, and I'll just leave it at that. And it doesn't help. And, you know, there are side effects for people. They gain weight. They have to take other medicines because they can't sleep. They stay up. I got super lucky that everything kind of, all my boxes are checked. That doesn't happen very often. This feels like a PSA for the stupid medicine, and I'm still not going to say what it is. Ask me privately, and maybe I'll tell you if you're struggling with this. But I have to say, man, bipolar is scary. I never know what is normal. My psychiatrist says there's no such thing as normal. I never know what is like an appropriate response versus my mind is just playing tricks on me. I can never tell the difference. I can now a little bit. I've been able to bite my tongue. I've been able to not just blurt out the thing that you're not supposed to say. Kanye West, take your medicine for fuck's sake. But I've been able to temper that. And usually my mouth has got me in trouble. So that's a good thing. But probably most importantly, that something that's impacted me this year is I've been able to make the films that I wanted to make and be the leader and director and producer that I've always wanted to be and show up for others and not flake out and not fall off a cliff of my own undoing and self-sabotage. I've been able to show up and be the best version of myself that I could be. Most people got to lick like a psychotropic frog to get those results. So I'm very grateful for that. And I'm saying this to document this moment in time. It's December 12th, 2022. I got on medicine March of this year. Been about 9 months or so. And I feel like a brand new person. Making the same mistakes, but I feel like a brand new person. That's a lyric to a song. Maybe some of you will catch that. Maybe some of you won't. But nevertheless, it rings true to me. I'm fortunate that I don't feel like unaliving myself anymore. I'm fortunate that I don't black out and disassociate anymore. I would have numerous amounts of blackouts a day. it sounds terrible to say. But I would just like show up at my house and be like, how did I get here? There were moments where I would go to work and I would just black out the whole thing and not be there, man. Like just be aloof. And now I'm present for everything, for better or worse, to a point where like, the anxiety is a little real, you know, but it's a normal, healthy thing. But I'm present and I show up for things that I normally used to just like leave my body for. Tons of great things, man. If you think you're struggling or if you are struggling and you've tried everything, do the best thing that you can do and ask for help. And someone that unlocked this for me, besides my wife, was the great and wonderful and legendary stand-up comedian, Maria Bamford. I read her book this year. I got back into reading, by the way. I stopped reading there for like 10 years. Got back into it. And Miriam Banford had a book on how to write like a 1 hour stand-up comedy special. And some of the advice that she gave was get your shitty ass help. Get your shitty ass help wherever it comes from. By any means necessary. Do whatever it takes and get your shitty ass help. Go to Al-Anon. Go to AA. It's free. Get free counseling if you can. Whatever it takes. Go in front of an open mic if it helps and talk about your fucking feelings if it helps. Get your free shitty ass help. And she's riddled with all kinds of things, you know, and it took her forever to find the medicine that helped her. And she seems to be doing pretty well today. So I'm happy for her. She deserves it. But she's a hero of mine because, dude, if you're like me and you're off and you're fucking weird and you can't control your feelings and you're just governed by, I mean, it feels like on some Gemini level, there are two monsters fighting within me. And if that sounds like you, get your shitty ass help. Do whatever it takes, man. Cause it's worth it. It's fucking worth it. And you belong here. You belong here. So yeah, I thought I would come out and just get this off my chest. It's been bugging me. It's been like this paralysis in a way of how am I going to make podcasts again, like 2020, where I was doing the daily grind. I loved doing that. Here we are. We're doing this first because if I can do this, I can say anything. If I can reveal myself here and be vulnerable and be naked and risk isolation and risk people dismissing you because of your mental health issues. And, you know, what are you going to do? You're going to fire me for something I was born with or whatever? Like, you can't hurt me. And that's why I'm saying this. Ooh, that's a book by David Goggins. Check that out. You can't hurt me. I'm proud to be here and I'm proud to have gotten through. So feel free to like and comment on this video. I'd love to hear your story on your mental health journey. Please share this with someone that you think might hear this. Share this with someone that you know needs to hear this because you can be okay and you can get better. It was able to happen for me and it was a hidden secret. Like the only people that really knew about this darkness, and I hate to use the word crazy, and this craziness, put an asterisk on that word. The only people that knew about this was Claire. And, you know, I've hidden these feelings from a great deal of people. And, you know, maybe my brother kind of knows about this too. And I don't want to keep it a secret anymore. So maybe it was obvious the whole time. If you've been following me for 10, 15 years, you've probably seen this coming. But as always, I'm always the last one to find these things out. I feel good. I feel good. I think that's it. I love you guys. My name is Knives Monroe. Keep a force field around your heart, and I'll see you guys on the next episode. Peace.